Y'all didn't think that I could bump like this. Said I told y'all I was gonna bump like this.
It's your girl, Hana. Thanks for tuning into my station. If you have not already subscribed, click on the link below and you will get alerts every time I post a crazy and funny video. I thank you all for your comments about my cheesy, easy, make and put a ring on it macaroni and cheese. So I said I should post a video on how to make a moist and juicy, yummy turkey. I didn't want you guys to think that I'm just a side dish girl. I can make the main menu. So stay tuned. Got the right turkey for our family. Let's talk about defrosting the turkey. This is a very important process. We have two options. I'm gonna let you know now that old school, leave that turkey on the countertop and let it just thaw out, it's not good. It's a harbor for bacteria and all kind of funky stuff. So here is the two options we have. The first option is you take that bird, you put it in the refrigerator, and you take 2 days and you let it thaw out. If you don't have 2 days, the second option would be to put it in some cold water. So you put it in a bucket or in a sink and put it in cold water. The thing about this process is you have to replenish that water every 30 minutes. If you don't do that, then it's just a place for bacteria to grow. And when we're dealing with poultry, we want to be as clean and precise with it so that it tastes good and it feels good going in.
Okay, so your turkey should be defrosting. So let's talk about the things quickly that we're going to need. I have this nice roasting pan. It's very nice. It comes with a top shelf that you can put the turkey on and the juices will go to the bottom and you can use it to reflavor the turkey and baize it out of there. Perfect. Again, I had a big wedding. I have a whole bunch of unnecessary kitchen items. If you don't have this, you can get a 99-cent store roasting aluminum pan and it will do the job. Second, we'll need is a flavor injector. We're going to need a baser. We're going to need an apple and an orange. We're going to put that inside the cavity of the turkey. I'll show you that. An olive oil, that's optional, and it's to keep the top of the bird brown. You can brush out olive oil, but you don't have to have it. Margarine or butter. Some of the spices we need is poultry seasoning, sage, black pepper, paprika, and all-purpose seasoning. And something my mom taught me is you can take bacon and put it on the top of a bird, and it will make it so juicy. So stay tuned so I can tell you all about it.
Most turkeys come with a net. If you have scissors, you can just cut this open. And what we're going to do right now is just clean and prepare this turkey. Okay, so lots of them have a lot of outside wrapping because you know this is poultry. What's really important is to make sure that your sink is super clean because we're dealing with raw poultry. So this top part, just be careful, cut the top off. Again, make sure this turkey is completely thawed while you're doing this. And here's our bird. Some of them come with wire and some of them come with string. Most of them are wire. You see, this is the thermometer here. And it is meant to pop up when it's finished. So we're over the sink. We got the turkey over the tray. And again, we're not going to mess with the thermometer. We're going to untie the legs, which I've done here, so we can get inside the inside cavity. Again, that's going to have the neck bone in there and all kind of things that you can use for dressing if you like. This is very important that we clean this bird out. So if you're gonna keep these for the dressing, you can do so. I'm not, I'm just gonna discard it. So I'm putting everything in a bag in there. So you're gonna have to get dirty, ladies. Roll up your sleeves, and we're gonna have to get inside this turkey and pull everything out. So see, ladies, I'm actually just taking the turkey belly side up and just letting this water get in here. You can actually let this water flow until the water starts being transparent. That's when you know the inside of the cavity is clean. Pat dry this bird, and he's a big boy. So what we're gonna do is just take his wings and we're gonna fold it under the breast. This is gonna help him cook and it's gonna be for presentation so that he looks cute. So we're gonna take that. You see how I just folded it under? This is the neck side. Fold it under and just sit them like that. And it's gonna make them look real pretty on the table. And it's also gonna help lock in the moisture. So you just take that wing. Ooh, and he's a big one. You fold it. Just like that. So see how big and pretty that turkey looks? Okay, so now we have successfully cleaned and now it's time to season. With the ingredients that I gave you guys pictures of earlier, I made a rub. Now this rub, we're going to rub on the, under the skin on top of the turkey. So what I've done is I made the rub. And we're going to separate the skin. You see, just go right up under. Be very careful because the turkey skin is tight and you don't want to rip it because it'll mess up your presentation. So go underneath the skin. Take just your hands. Make sure they're very clean. Get that rub in there and rub this baby down. You see that underneath the skin? On the breast, underneath the skin. Ingredients injector. So what you're going to do is melt some butter. You're going to need way more than this, but I'm just doing a demo for you. And you're going to take it without the ending on it, and you're going to pull it back just like you're drawing a needle or something. You put it inside the butter, and you just pull it back. See that? That's butter. So then what we're going to do is screw the end of this on, and we're gonna inject this turkey with flavor. So the areas that I do it is the breast. I do it once on the back, and I do these big thighs, and you can do the wing as well. Wing end doesn't usually get dry, but go for it. So you're just gonna go right up underneath the skin. Sorry, my injector is brand new. It had its seal on it. You're gonna go right up underneath the skin. And we're just going to slowly inject this turkey with this butter. And as you can see, it's going to start to swell. That's nothing but flavor. And just slowly, the slower you inject it, the better the butter will stay inside. You see how that's getting fat there? That's that butter going in there. I've covered the turkey with the bacon. You just lay it across, ladies, very easy. I have him in his roasting pan. We're gonna take these apples and this orange and put him in that cavity. And then we are ready to put him in the oven. And see as the juices fall down here at the bottom of the pan, you see that? While that is cooking, we're gonna be able to take this baster and just get it right out of there, put it back on top, right out of there, put it back on top. And we're going to do that every 30 minutes to every 45 minutes, okay? So I'll see you guys in a couple of hours. We're on the home stretch now. This is before the last hour has approached with the turkey. What you're going to do is you're going to take out this apple and orange out the inside. Just discard it. It's done its job. Mine is in there good. Be careful because that pot is still hot. And then we're just going to carefully take the bacon off. It's also done its job. It's sealed in the moisture. You can just take that off. Now the remaining juice that's at the bottom, you're going to do like you did every hour. Just get it out that bottom and re-put it on top of the turkey. Now, if you're satisfied with the color of the turkey, then you're going to wrap it in aluminum foil for the last hour so it doesn't get any browner. And what you're going to do is you're going to make it in a dome shape so that it does not touch the turkey. So you're just going to gently place it on top. Do the sides a little firm. Be careful because it's hot. And just leave a pocket on top like that, like a dome, so that it doesn't touch it. You put it in for its last hour, and then it's ready to serve. Like, our bird is done. That timer did pop up, which you don't always want to trust it, but it looks like it was good. If you have a thermometer, you can inject it into the thickest meat of the turkey, which is up here, and it should give you a register of 160 to 165. And 170 inside the legs. You can see that paprika makes it look red, but that's all seasoning. A good way to test it is to take the thickest part of the breast and inject a fork in there. If the juices that come out are clear, which you can see they are, see that clear juice coming out? That turkey's done. So we're ready to let it sit for about 20 to 30 minutes so that all the juices can do its thing, and then we'll come back and transfer it into a pretty platter and have it ready to be cut. They get invited late night grande roses, all right, but we love it how the club vibrating is enticing. Let the beat knock.
trust me, we ain't gonna stop. Head to the lights up, watch us take over the spot. Few mad looks from them chicks, you know, and from them dudes who be jealous of a chick with dough.